Good morning, guys. My name is Antonio Vieira. Today we'll be talking about how to analyze a poem. What is a poem? A poem is a piece of writing in which the expression of feelings and ideas are given intensity by focusing on diction, sometimes involving rhyme, rhythm, and imagery. Okay, let's start. These are the components that we should take into account when analyzing a poem. We have, the first one is read it at least twice. When we start analyzing a poem, we read it at least twice. It could be three times, four times. By doing that, it helps us analyze a poem. Just like when we read a text that we have never read before, we read it once, then we need to read it another time. Why? Because only one time we're not able to identify the meaning of that text accordingly. So we read the poem once, twice, if necessary, three times, four times, and so forth. Once we have done it, it will help us analyze the poem itself accordingly. The second one is look for literal meaning. What does that tell us? What does that mean? Looking for literal meaning means are there words there we do not understand? Are there places there we don't know of? Okay? So if there are words we do not understand, what we do, we look up in the dictionary for those words. We look up for those words in the dictionary, and if there are places we do not know of, we do the same. We go online, we look for a Wikipedia, encyclopedia, etc., and then we read about those places. By doing that, it will help us analyzing the poem and discussion. The third one is analyze the title. Okay? When we analyze a poem, we look at the title. The title, does the title tell us what the subject is? Okay? We analyze it. Oftentimes, the titles summarize the entire poem. So we look at the title. We analyze it, we try to connect the title to the body, the stanzas of the poem. We'll see if we can get the main idea in the poem, okay? The fourth one is identify the tone. What is the tone? The tone is like the speaker's point of view. Whoever wrote the poem had an idea and a reason. So by identifying the tone, we'll be able to know what is the speaker's point of view, what the writer wants to tell us. Okay? What is the reason behind is writing that poem? Okay? We'll try to identify the tone in the poem. The fifth one is check for sound and rhythm, okay? Are there rhyme schemes in the poem, okay? We have many types of meters. As we know, we have iambic pentameter, we have tochaic, we have spondee, we have pyrrhic, we have monometer, dimeter, anapestic, and so forth, and many other meters, types of meters in a poem. So what we do, we try to see if there's a rhyme scheme, if there are different types of meters in the poem, okay? And that will help us analyze the poem as a whole. The sixth one is identify figures of speech. Oftentimes, The poems have many figures of speech. We have metaphor, personification, simile, and many other symbolism, and many other figures of speech. By analyzing those figures of speech, we'll be able to get to what we are trying to get to identify the main idea of the poem. And in turn, we'll be able to identify the meaning as a whole in the poem. Conclusion. By doing all these things I've just talked about, we will we'll be able to put your poem together, get your main idea out of the poem. Once we do that, by doing this, relating this to this, okay? Then we'll get your main idea of the poem. Thank you very much for watching. That's what I had to share today with you guys. I'll see you next time.